Never before had the Bergsons seen, nor had they heard, such a vast trove of myth and legends. They were so mesmerized by Apon's storytelling that they spent the whole night transfixed as her audience. The divine and a reward waiting.
Fuck!
Steps were taken without regret, for it was never possible to change a destiny unknown. The wish that their mother was alive was a shared longing for Ben and John. The younger son placed Margaret's staff on the same pedestal he had taken his father's sword from, his mind wondering about the truth of the horrific secret that their mother had left for them in her final letter. Soon, the Bergsons would have to face Bushra, the villainous ruler of Barahut, and lover of the wind spirit. Agitated, Ben was pointing out the passes that led to the halls of Anairaha. John, however, was lost in his thoughts. Thoughts that only Mark could guess. What else would the oppressed slaves ask for in their prayers to the spirits of the land but a return to freedom and happiness? The Bergson wondered whether a Nairaha could answer the prayers, or if his sleep proved too deep to even hear his people's cries. Adam continues about their run-ins with the bandits. Chamber touched only by earth, wind, the powers that be. Something more sinister would be appearing soon. Yeah. hammer struck chisel, carving out stone and creating elegant designs for the harsh sand to wear down. Broken fingers and crushed hands were an accepted cost. Left behind was a most curious stone. A warmth filled the hero's body on contact with it, embracing them in comfort. Uncle Ben would certainly have something to say about this strange stone. His hands trembled near constantly, only calming a touch of stone. In the forgotten room, a relic of power. Steps were taken without regret, for it was never possible to change a destiny unknown. God of the free wind, now tethered to the ground. His voice to the people, now just the warden of his prison. The air touched him, filling him and ruffling his feathers. He looked upon the Bergson, small and fragile, but so full of hope. Infectious hope. Perhaps this would be the last time.
Thank you.
The spirit's words took life, forming images to reveal what was hidden from the Bergsons. And so it was their fate to do battle. The children of Rhea Dana on the cusp of victory would find their world overrun with the corrupted, drowning them. And when they could fight no more, they would bow to Ooze demand. But there was no salvation in fighting his corruption. By giving a heart-wrenching sacrifice, they would stay the god's thirst for mere centuries. Children of Rhea Dana, the Bergson's destiny, how much of it Grandma had found out before her demise were the subject of much speculation among the family. Speculation without certainty. When Linda told them about Mary's deterioration, they knew they had to do something to prevent another catastrophe. Mark tried to help with his knowledge of herbs. He knew that somewhere around Berahat was a tree, and an extract of its seeds might help stop Mary's chills and fever. But Berahat had surrendered to the corruption. Not even the trees were safe from it.